Picture this, you're teaching math to 7th graders over Zoom, and you can practically hear the collective groan when quiz time comes. Sound familiar? Imagine turning a simple form into a thrilling digital escape room that keeps students engaged, sparks creativity, and tests problem solving all without writing down any code. Welcome to the power of Jotform. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a thrilling digital escape room that'll have your students begging for more math questions. As a middle school teacher, or any teacher, honestly, you've probably noticed that traditional quizzes and worksheets just don't cut it anymore, especially in remote learning environments. Your students feel isolated, bored, and disengaged when faced with another Google Form quiz. They're staring at bland questions with no visual appeal or interactive elements to keep them interested. You've tried Google Forms because it's free and familiar, but let's be honest, it's pretty limiting. You can't easily add multimedia content, create branching logic that responds to answers, or build the sense of adventure your students crave. The result, students click through mindlessly and miss the actual learning you're trying to achieve. Here's where Jotform changes everything for you. Jotform combines an easy drag and drop interface with advanced features that Google Forms simply can't match. You can add images, videos, audio clips, and countdown timers to create truly immersive experiences. The real game changer is that conditional logic that only lets students advance when they solve puzzles correctly is there, plus automatic submission tracking so you can monitor packages and progress without any work. I absolutely love how Jotform integrates with tools like Google Drive and Slack, making it super easy to organize your results and share them with your colleagues. Instead of dreading quiz day, your students will be asking when the next escape room challenge is coming. You'll transform boring assessments into adventures that actually boost engagement and learning outcomes. Let me show you exactly how this transformation happens. We'll start by seeing the limitations of Google Forms. Then I'll demonstrate how Jotform solves these challenges. First, let's create a basic escape room using Google Forms so you can see what we're working with. Let's start with setting up a new form. In the upper right corner of the Google page, we're gonna click the Google Apps icon to open the app menu. In the app menu, you're going to need to scroll down and click the Forms icon to navigate to Google Forms. Next, we're going to create our form. In the Start a New Form section at the top of the screen, let's click the blank form template to create a new empty form. You'll see a greeting pop-up appear in the center of the screen, and we're going to click the X in the upper right corner to close it. Now we're going to set up our form title and description. At the top of the form, let's click on the Untitled Form text to edit the title. We'll type Escape Room Quiz, the mystery at midnight, into the title field to name our quiz. And now we're gonna type the introduction text into the description field to provide context for the escape room. Let's say we're gonna write, you're trapped in a mysterious mansion at midnight. To escape, you must solve each riddle task in order. Don't use Google, use your brain instead. Every correct answer gives you a clue to move on. Write your answers clearly in the spaces provided. Solve all the puzzles to escape the haunted mansion. Good luck. This will set the stage for your quiz. Let's create our first riddle. On the floating toolbar to the right of the form, we're gonna click the Add Question plus icon to insert a new question. We'll type the first riddle, riddle one, the locked door. I speak without a mouth and hear without ears. I have no body, but I come alive with wind. What am I? Into the question field. Here's where we need to set up validation. To the right of the question field, let's click the drop-down menu to change the question type. We'll select short answer from the drop-down list to allow users to type their own answer. At the bottom right of the question box, we're gonna click the required toggle to make this question mandatory. Moving on to response validation to the right of the required toggle, let's click the three-dot more options icon. We'll select response validation from the menu that appears to set rules for the correct answer. On the far left or the new validation rule, now we're going to click the drop-down menu and select text from the drop-down menu to set the validation for a text-based answer. In the text field in the middle of the validation rule, we're gonna type echo to set the correct answer. In the custom error text field on the right, let's type not quite, try again, to provide feedback for incorrect answers. To delete a question field, click on the second untitled question box. And then at the bottom of the question box, we'll click the delete question trash can icon to remove it. Let me quickly add the remaining riddles, following the same pattern. For riddle two, we'll create riddle two, the secret code. The code is hidden in the numbers below. At the first and last, then add the first and last, then subtract the middle. Numbers are gonna be 8, -3, -5, with the answer as 10. An error message, the lock stays shut, try again. After that, we'll add riddle three. Riddle three is gonna be the hidden room. The more you take away, the bigger I become. What am I? With the answer, hole. An error message, the door doesn't respond. Try again. Then riddle number 4 is going to be a word puzzle, and it's going to have rearrange the letters to find the word D-E-H-A with answer head and the same error message. Finally, riddle 5 is going to be the final escape, the beginning of eternity, the end of time and space, the beginning of every end and the end of every place with answer E and error message, the door won't budge. Look closer. Now here's what we've created. It's pretty simple and it works, but it's honestly pretty bland. The questions are there, the logic functions, but there's no visual, anything that gets me excited, no multimedia, no sense of adventure. It's just a regular quiz. This is where Jotform completely changes the game. Let's head over to jotform.com and create an account. Here's the best part. Once you're logged in, you can access the digital escape room template. We're gonna click start customizing, and page 1 is gonna be displayed in the first section. You'll see a property icon appear on the right side of the section, and we're gonna click on that to open our customization options. Now a new pane appears on the right side where we can transform the template. We're going to customize the template by adding text in the heading box. We'll say, welcome to greet our students, then click on the subheading text box to change it. We'll type, sit back, relax, and do your best. Good luck, to set the tone. Let's close the pane and go to page 3 to see more customization options. We'll click on the section and then click on the properties icon. Here, you can see how you can customize the page image by adding an image, adjusting the image size or image alignment. This is where the visual transformation really happens. Now let's locate the single choice properties in the subsection on page 3 and customize it according to your needs. We're gonna make answering this page mandatory. We'll repeat the same process for all sections to adjust the template according to your situation and purpose. Imagine you're a middle school math teacher. Your students are attending class online due to the ongoing hybrid schedules. You want to teach basic logic and motivate them to think in a fun way. But students, they often groan when they see a quiz coming. Instead of that traditional test read, you've created escape room quiz, the mystery at midnight, using Jotform's template. Students now see atmospheric images, hear mysterious sound effects, and watch a countdown timer that adds real urgency to their problem solving. Each section uses conditional logic, so only students with correct answers move forward. Still, now it feels like progressing through an actual escape room rather than just answering questions. The multimedia elements create excitement that keeps students engaged throughout the entire experience. By the end of the session, students are actively solving problems, collaborating in breakout rooms, and genuinely enjoying the challenge. You've not only taught logic and problem solving effectively, but also boosted engagement, critical thinking skills, and teamwork. This feature is amazing for cutting down on the time you spend creating engaging content because Jotform's template system gives you a professional foundation from which to build. Unlike Google Forms, you get multimedia support, conditional branching, timers, and custom themes all in one platform. The drag and drop interface means you don't need any coding skills to create these immersive experiences. Your students will trust the process because they can start immediate visual feedback and feel genuine progression through each challenge. The automatic submission tracking saves you hours of manual grading, while integrations with Google Drive and Slack help you organize results seamlessly. Here's how you know this works. When students start asking for more escape room challenges instead of dreading quiz time, you'll see the real power of interactive learning in action. Want to captivate your students with a thrilling digital escape room? Zero code required. Head over to Jotform, sign up for free, and start with the digital escape room template. In minutes, you'll have an immersive experience ready to share. Let the adventure begin. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.